And now, RSM, the Rams Sports Magazine Show.
Good evening and welcome to RSM, Rams Sports Magazine Show. I'm your host, Anthony Keith. This week is a huge one for the CSU football team as they prepare to face the number 5 Boise State Broncos. As for the volleyball squad, well, they dropped out of the top 25 AVCA polls for the first time this season. But I'm going to stick with football to start things off as I checked in with the team at practice earlier this week. What would a win mean to this team this weekend?
I mean, that's what you work for, so that's why you play the game of football. I mean, honestly, any game's winnable, but this opponent's obviously going to be the hardest we've faced. So,
how nice is it having a bye before facing number 5 Broncos?
I mean, it's got its pros and cons, I guess. You know, lets you get off your feet and get your legs back under you. But I mean, it's obviously been 2 weeks since we played, but just go out here and practice hard, and it shouldn't be a big deal.
What's the atmosphere been like with the team preparing for this Boise State team?
I mean, we're just getting ready, you know. Just another day at the office, I guess you could say. So
plain and simple, you're treating this game like any other, preparing the same way. There's no extra motive behind it.
I mean, playing the number 5th team in the country, there's a lot of extra motive actually, but you got to respect them like any other team. And I mean, you can't treat them like gods, because you got to go into every week expecting to win. Like, it's like our linebacker coach Clark said today. He goes, if you don't go into every week expecting a win, then you shouldn't even be playing football.
Very true. Can't be arguing that. Now, the defense obviously plagued with injuries. You yourself have stepped into a pretty big role. How have they been meshing lately?
I think we're doing all right. I mean, Shaq was still getting reps. Back when I was playing Mike, Shaq was still in there getting reps. And, I mean, he's getting a lot of experience now. But I think me, Shaq, and Arakpo, we work really well together. And then the D-line's coming together well. And I think we look pretty good out there.
You guys are taking on Kellen Moore. I mean, what's that mean to you?
Not much. I mean, he's a great quarterback. So we just – it's like I said, we got to respect their team. We got to respect him. But, I mean, just got to play.
There's a good defense. They play fast, they're big, they're physical. They get pressure on the quarterback. They stop the run real well, and their DBs man up the receivers. So it's going to be a huge challenge for us.
This much better are you prepared? You guys have been doing better in the passing game recently. How much better prepared are you now to go against that kind of defense than you were maybe 3-4 weeks ago?
We just have a lot more confidence in the passing game. Obviously, that San Jose State gave us a lot of confidence in the pass game. Obviously, Boise's going to be a little tougher than San Jose State, but I think we're going to be up for it, and it's a huge challenge for us. They're one of the best teams in the country, so we're really going to find out where we are as a team.
What are the big changes you've seen from your receivers? Lou Greenwood in particular, you hit him deep a couple times, Thomas Kaufman. What are the big changes you've seen in them in the last few
weeks? I think they're just a little more in tune to the small details, route running, the specific details of the route, fourth, inside step, whatever it may be, and they're catching the ball real well. It obviously helps when I put the ball where it needs to be. I mean, it all starts with me and being accurate, and if I'm accurate with the ball, they're going to make plays. I think they can run by anyone and make catches, and they show that against San Jose State.
You've had games this year where the running game's worked. The last couple games, the passing game has. Is this not the perfect opportunity to kind of have a meeting of the minds and have them play off each other this week?
Right. I mean, this is one of the biggest games of the year for us, and in order to have a chance to win this game, we're going to have to put our run game and pass game together, and we're working real hard to do that, so we'll see what happens out there on Saturday.
Is there anything particular, because like Steve said last week in during the bye week, you were able to go back to basics, get some things down pat, bread and butter stuff you do well. What particular things do you think gave you confidence coming out of doing that?
I don't know the specific things he's talking about, but last week,
what was your feel? I mean,
keep getting the timing down with the receivers, hitting them in stride on a deep in route instead of kind of making them stop and slide for the ball so he can catch and get upfield, put a little more air on the deep ball so they can run underneath it. Just being perfect in the run game, making the right checks so the linemen know what to do. I think we just really came together as an offense even during the bye week. So I'm really excited to see how we do out on Saturday.
This game, how different are you guys preparing for this because it is Boise State?
We're playing hard. I mean, we just trying to prepare with as little mistakes as possible, make sure we're executing our plays and playing together, and I think that we can pull it off. So
has practice been any different this week? I mean, you got to obviously practice on Monday. That was different. But are the guys preparing differently?
Yeah. I mean, we're just preparing mentally and physically wise because it's going to be a physical game, and it's going to be as much as your mind on your body. So we got to just be ready to play, fear. fierce and hard all four quarters.
Don't hold back on this question. What would a win? What would a win mean to you guys?
Be a big time for us, a big time plus, a lot of confidence booster, and we're just going to get ready to keep momentum into all these games, so it'll be great.
Coach Child said you guys are preparing for this team like any other, but reality, I mean, this is Boise State you guys are playing. How are you feeling about this game?
You know, we are really preparing like every other team, but in the back of my mind, you think that's number five team. You know, they're good, but good group of guys. You know, you just got to do that extra thing, whether it's extra, you know, a little work on the field or a little bit of film in the film room. You know, you just got to prepare thoroughly for this team. They're a pretty good group. They're a pretty good team.
Now, this is such a big team. A lot of people are expecting them to win. I mean, they're 5-0 right now. Is this a win-win situation for you guys? I mean, even if you lose, so many people expect it. But if you win, that's big money right there.
Yeah, it is big money. You know, that's why we got shot people. We're the only people that believe we can win this game. You know, we got a pretty good pass rush, pretty good coverage. You know, they like to pass the ball. They also like to run the ball. But, you know, we got a pretty good scheme going against them guys. If we can execute and dominate every phase of the game, we should win.
It's another big thing. They've only allowed about half a sack per game with Kellen Moore. Now, you're the sack master, man. So tell me, how many sacks do you think you can pull out against Kellen Moore this game?
As much as possible, man. If I can't sack, if I get close, man, I'm knocking them down, you know, trying to make them feel the heat, trying to make them feel uncomfortable as possible. You know, if you feel uncomfortable, throw some incompletion. Hopefully, you force a mistake or two.
Don't go anywhere just yet. Coming up after the break, I speak one-on-one with wide receiver Lou Greenwood, who had an amazing game against San Jose State and hopes to do the same against the Broncos this Saturday. Stay tuned.
You're watching RSM, the Rams Sports Magazine Show on Northern Colorado 5.
Welcome back to the show, Rams fans. A few weeks ago, Lou Greenwood, junior wide receiver, played an amazing game against San Jose State, catching for about 150 yards and two touchdowns. So I had to talk to the junior earlier this week. This week, I'm joined by wide receiver Lou Greenwood, who had an amazing game against San Jose State a few weeks ago. Now, it was a pretty big game for you. Had about 150 yards receiving two touchdowns, you know, first two of the season. Yeah. It's been some time with the bye week, but what have you really taken away from that San Jose State game?
Well, I mean, obviously that was a tough loss. I mean, we wanted to get away with that one, but that showed we could fight. We can fight back. Cause I mean, we got down early and late, but we fought back, and I mean, we made it the game regardless of the loss. So I feel like that game kind of brought us together. You know what
That's
I'm saying? So,
always a good thing. Yeah. Now, talking about bringing together this bye week, was this the perfect time for a bye week? Right before you face a number five team?
Yeah, I mean, cause they gave us all last week to look and watch film on them, you know, and then we got the rest and get the bruises and bumps back fixed. So it was good to get a week off. But, I mean, it's over now and we're back at it. So
very true. Yeah. That passing game really opened up against San Jose State. Yeah. Has that shown in practice this week? Has there been a lot of, you know, long bombs to Mr. Greenwood?
Well, I mean, we've been practicing a few. But, I mean, when we get in the game Saturday, you know, everything will change. So we'll see. But I think we're going to have to air it out because, I mean, that D-line is – AD line is amazing, so we're going to have to air it out.
Once the run game stops working for a little bit, they'll be looking for those deep receivers. They are the number 13 team when it comes to passing defense. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, does that intimidate you, or, you know, is this just another opponent for you?
No, I mean, I don't really care. I don't care at all about that. It'll be fun. I mean, it's Boise State. They're number five, so we're just going to go ahead and have fun. See what happens.
Number five, have fun. Look for that win. Yep. But tell me, what would a win mean for this school, for the community, for you?
I mean, a win to beat Boise, it's like, for the last 2 years, each team has came and said, okay, well, what can we do to beat Boise? And I mean, for us to beat them, it'll be like, it'll be amazing. I mean, it'll be bigger than beating CU, I feel like. I mean, it'll put us not only on a local map, but a national map, you know what I'm saying? It'll be amazing, but that's a big step for us. And I mean, if we do it, we deserve it. If we don't, then, you know, hey, but that'll be great.
Yeah, you guys win this game, it'll be all over the national spotlight for weeks. Yeah. One thing with the Boise State Broncos, they're the big blue, they got the blue field. A lot of people are talking smack before the season, you know, the advantage. And they're like, what about CSU, green on green? Well, you guys are going all white this Saturday, so I can't complain about that.
Yeah.
The purpose behind that, they're looking to, you know, white out cancer. Essentially, you guys are playing for a big cause that day. You know, there's a reason behind the game. What does that mean to you, this white out movement?
I mean, since I've been here, this is my third year here, and it's my first time ever wearing white, you know, in Hughes Stadium. So first off, that'd be good. And I mean, cancer, that's a big problem in the world. So I mean, to white out that, it'd be fun. But it'll just be fun because, I mean, they're gonna wear their blue. I've always wanted to see their blue uniform because they look good on TV. So I mean, it'll be a good experience.
Definitely. Yeah. Again, going on that white, the uniforms you guys are wearing, is that even in the back of your mind for most games? You know, are you trying to look flashy for the cameras? Because it's national television.
I mean, it It'll look good, but it really don't matter to me. I mean, we can look good and play bad, or look really bad and play good. So, I mean, it'll be fun.
Can't argue that.
Yeah, it'll be experience. It'll be one of those things 10 years from now, I can look back and be like, I played in that whiteout game against Boise State that year.
That's awesome.
And then to beat them, it'll just be like, you know, that's something I can tell my kids. They probably won't care, but, you know, that's something I can brag about forever. They'll act like they care.
Yeah. Now, this Saturday, it's kind of reaching that midway point of the season. You know, you guys are 3-2. How are you feeling that the passing game has really evolved with Thomas?
If you look at us from game one, it's like we took from game one to game two, I feel like we kind of regressed. But since then, it's been, you watch us, it's just been amazing, you know, to see how we've been airing it out, you know. And, I mean, our passing game was a big question mark going into the season. But I feel like that San Jose State game and that Utah State game kind of, you know, showed, well, hey, you know, they can do more than run the ball. So
That was the big problem, is he didn't really have a go-to guy this season to start out. Mm-hmm. Are you starting to feel a little more like that go-to guy?
Sure. I mean, if that's what you want to call me, I'll be that.
But you're taking the modest way.
It'll be fun. I mean, I just can't wait. I cannot wait.
This is the highest ranked team, well, number five team. You guys took on TCU last year. You know, that was another number five team coming here to Fort Collins.
Yeah.
Are you kind of relating those two games and how you're preparing for it?
Honestly, I can't remember how we prepared for that TCU game last year, but we played a good game. I mean,
you had an 18-yard catch, I believe, in that game.
If we could have made some touchdowns, that game would have went differently. But I feel like that game kind of sets the stage for this game. You know what I'm saying? Because we played them last year. They went on to win the Rose Bowl, and they beat us by 23 points. And, I mean, in football, that's not much.
Oh, man.
So, you know, boys, it'll be like, well, you know, if we go out here and play hard, you know, anything can happen. So that's why I feel like that game last year was like a good follow-up to this Boise game.
So incredibly important to get that offense rolling in the first half of this game. It's been a problem with you guys, is the first quarter offense isn't there as much as the second and fourth quarter.
Yeah.
So, you know, as far as preparing this week, the excitement level, how is everybody feeling heading into the Saturday
matchup?
I mean,
like I said, like, it's Boise State. That's enough said. You know what I'm saying? They're number five. They're blue. I mean, they obviously feel like they're going to come in and beat us. So, I mean, we got a chip on our shoulders.
There you go.
So, it's going to be a good experience. I mean, I feel like it's going to be packed. You know, the whiteout. We're going to have the surroundings to do it, if we ever were.
Well, that's the big thing, too. You're playing in front of a full house. This is the last question for you. Playing in front of a packed Hughes Stadium. Yeah. What does that mean to you?
This will be my first one. Like, I'll live to tell my kids about it, but it'll be fun. I mean, I can't wait. I mean, this is the vibe. The vibe already in Hughes is like, you know, crazy, but full and sold out and all white is even better. We boys in the house, so.
It's going to be some good stuff.
It will be.
Lou, I want to wish you good luck. Man. Hopefully you come out of this game 4-2. There's still plenty more to come on the show, so stay tuned, Rams fans. Coming up next on RSM, I go from the gridiron to the court as I talk to the volleyball team who just recently fell out of the top 25 AVCA polls with a loss to Wyoming. Stay tuned.
You're watching RSM, the Rams Sports Magazine Show on Northern Colorado 5.
The CSU volleyball team suffered their first conference loss last weekend against the Wyoming Cowgirls. However, they hope to rebound this week against two very tough opponents, UNM and TCU. So I spoke to Coach Tom Hilbert earlier this week.
First big thing, obviously 3-2 lost to Wyoming. Looking at the stat sheet, you guys should have won that match. Kind of tell me what happened aside from that last set where there were a few mistakes.
Well, volleyball is an interesting game in that you can control 80% of a match, and if you play poorly for the other 20%, if it's a critical time, you can lose the match. We're ahead 2-0, we're ahead in the third, and we let it slip. Then we lose the fourth, we're way ahead in the fifth, and we let it slip. So you have to be good at critical times. Wyoming was, and we weren't. And although overall we played a pretty good match, we didn't compete at crunch time, and as a result, we took a loss.
Talking about critical times, crunch time, this week, UNM, TCU, you know, two of those top teams in the Mountain West. How important is this week, and how are you feeling coming into it after practice today?
Well, we're feeling good. I mean, we're a good enough team when we're playing at our best to beat everybody in our league, but we have to learn how to control ourselves and play at that high level over long periods of time. And, you know, I feel good about our team against both of these opponents. They're both good. It's certainly going to be difficult matches. They're going to be challenging and hard, but we like playing here in Moby. There's a lot of energy here for us, and so I feel good about it.
You guys are 6-1 at Moby, not including the exhibition match. But, I mean, going on the road, you guys are 3-3. How different is that, the Moby games, the road matches for this team this year compared to teams in the past?
It's been very different. And, you know, I think that we're an okay team on the road, but we've got to understand how to compete. You know what I mean? We have to understand how to really play well at certain critical points, and that has hurt us.
Very important. Now this UNM game, it's going to be televised, third televised game for this program this season. What does that mean for you as a coach, getting that exposure out there?
Well, it's great. We love the Mountain, and just like we love NOCO 5, but we feel like volleyball is a great television sport, and they do a great job of producing it. Our league gets a lot of good televised games. We've got good, exciting teams to watch, so people need to tune in.
UNM's also coming off of a loss, but what worries you most with this Lobos team?
I think when you come off of a loss that you don't think you should have gotten, which UNM probably should have won that match against San Diego State. They kind of pulled the same kind of deal that we did against Wyoming. That gives you more of a sense of urgency, gives you a little chip on your shoulder, and they will come into this gym energized, alert, and ready to play hard. And so I think that loss probably makes them better here than they would have been.
You say the same for TCU, who was 16-1 until last week. Now they're 16-3.
Yeah, I would say that because I don't understand, and I haven't watched the TCU yet, but I'm sure they've got a chip on their shoulder too, and they're good. Obviously, they won 16 out of 17 of their first matches, so they're doing something right.
You're reaching that midway point of conference play. I'm just curious, you know, obviously Deidre has really stepped it up, you know, into that new position, but are there any other players that are really standing out to you that are improving every week?
Yes, Kate Steffen, who is playing a new position, and she's been good, but she's getting better and better and better, and she's now, we're getting productivity out of her that is equal or better than outside hitters that we've had in this program for the last 4 or 5 years. So it's really exciting to see the things she's doing. I really like her. And I think both of our outsides, Dana Cranston's doing a good job. So we've got to get our middles and our right side players performing at a high level every match, and then we have 5 weapons and we're real good.
Now that you've heard from the head honcho, Tom Hilbert, coming up next after the break, I speak to the preseason Mountain West Conference Player of the Year, Megan Plord, as she prepares to take on UNM and TCU.
You're watching RSM, the Ram Sports Magazine Show on Northern Colorado 5.
Welcome back to the show, Rams fans. For the first time in 2011, the CSU volleyball team has fallen out of the top 25 AVCA rankings. However, they stay positive as they head into a very critical week of matches against the University of New Mexico and TCU.
Talk about that Wyoming match. What went wrong there?
It was definitely a tough loss for us. We kind of broke down, I think, at the end of that third game. We should have closed it out, and just a few errors at the end of the match, and then they gave them some point runs. And same with the fifth game. I mean, we're up 9-3, and they had that point run. We gave some points to them, and it's definitely a tough loss, but we're moved on, and we're looking forward and can't dwell on the past.
Well, I don't want to dwell too much on the past, but looking at those stats, I mean, you guys seem to beat them in every category, minus the errors, which you guys only had one more. What are you taking away from that loss? How are you going to rebound from that?
No, definitely. If you look at the stats, it's very odd, just because our stats are a lot higher than theirs. I think we had to serve a lot tougher, is what we decided, just because their hitting percentage is a lot higher than ours. So we definitely need to pick up serving tougher.
This week is a critical one. You got New Mexico, TCU. Both teams are up there in the Mountain West. But you guys are 6-1 at home. So, I mean, what advantage does that give you this week, being at home for these two matches?
It's definitely an advantage for us. I mean, since our last game was away at Wyoming, it was a loss. So it'll be nice to come back with the Moby magic and kind of get back into the swing of things.
You guys are 3-3 on the road. Is it the road? I mean, is that kind of a problem with the traveling? How hard is that going away for a game?
I mean, it's very difficult when you go away, definitely into different areas, just because like when we went to Wyoming, the altitude is a lot higher, so the ball is a lot lighter for us for passing and serving. So there's definitely a lot of obstacles when you go on the road, but Yeah, it definitely has shown through our losses on the road.
Now, after these two matches, you've hit that midway point for the conference. So you've got a taste, an idea. Tell me, how do you feel about this Mountain West Conference with the tournament in place? How you guys are going to do this year?
I definitely feel like I'm really confident in our team right now. I feel like we're going to finish strong, and we know that we need to be at our best when it's the tournament time in November. So we're going to be at that point.
Obviously, one of the vets is a junior middle blocker. You're leading the team in blocks with about 1.5 per set. But kind of talk about your own personal, how you feel you're doing right now. Are you where you want to be, or do you have any goals you personally want to reach?
Personally, I guess I just want to keep improving on the hitting just because me and D just our first season together. Getting used to each other, I guess. We have been improving with the sets and connecting with each other. So definitely just improving on hitting with her.
He has been on top of that this season. This week, looking at the New Mexico match, it's going to be nationally televised. What does that mean to you guys? This is the third time you guys are going to be on TV.
Yeah, definitely it's very exciting for us. Hopefully we can get a big crowd out there to support us. And it's always exciting to be on TV, so extra motivation for us.
There you go. That Lobos team isn't looking as good as a lot of people expect them to be. I mean, they expected, as far as votes-wise, preseason to be head-to-head with you guys. What are you worried about with this team tomorrow?
Definitely I would say Ashley Rhodes, just their middle. If you look at the stats, she's getting a lot of their balls and she's a very athletic player, so we need to make sure that we stop her and don't let her get rolling on her swings, I guess.
So you've kind of got her picked out as a target then in that case. You're going to take her down. No, I'm just kidding. But then at the same time, this week in TCU, this is a team that last week they dropped two, but before that they were 16-1. They were receiving votes in the country. You know, that match, are you getting nervous for that match? Are you excited for that competition?
I'm definitely excited. It's always fun to play TCU just because they are a tough team to play, and they have been playing really well this year. So I'm definitely more excited than nervous to play them because it's always more fun to play a better team than not so good of a team.
Now, I hate bringing this up because I know how you guys feel about the rankings, but you guys fell out of the rankings for the first time this season. How do you feel about that?
Honestly, I'm not too worried about it. I guess we don't really worry about the rankings, and like we can't control outside stuff, so just go with what we want.
That'll do it this week for RSM, but tune in next week as I'll have highlights of that huge Boise State game, and I check back in with the volleyball team. Catch you next week.